Before we get into this video, I want to let you guys know that my G Fuel code is still 30% off. We are still competing in the G Fuel March Madness. Must I remind you guys that the winner of the G Fuel March Madness tournament gets their own shaker cup. So you guys see this PewDiePie shaker cup. Imagine a sharp shaker cup. You guys can use my code by purchasing a tub of G Fuel, a starter pack of G Fuel, or you can even get the $4.99 pack of three if you just wanted to try G Fuel out and also give me a code usage. I do appreciate it. Link will be down in the description. Thank you guys very much. Hope you guys enjoy the video. Also, make sure you guys are subscribed. If you're not subscribed, let's get right into it.
Yo,
what is going on YouTube? Sharp here, Bernie has another video, and today we are going to be watching some videos from my boy, Stephen J. Harvey. I don't even know if Jay is his real middle name. What is Steve Harvey's middle name? Linda wants to guess. I bet, actually, you know what? Stephen Q. Harvey. He looks like he have a Quincy as his middle name. You think his middle name is Steve? His fucking middle name is Stephen. His first name is Broderick, it looks like it's Broderick, but I'm guessing it's Broderick Stephen Harvey. I mean, I guess if they were fucking introducing him like, da-da-da-da-da, and then your host, Broderick Harvey, it wouldn't sound right. It's gotta be Steve. But yes, we're gonna be watching some of the funniest moments from Family Feud. Love this show growing up, love this show now. I think one year me and my family were gonna like submit a tape because they were coming to Kentucky. And we were going to submit a tape to be on the show, but we never did. Probably should have done it. Could have turned out to be like Ninja. We could still do it. I think they filmed a bunch of episodes here in Atlanta. So we could Family Feud this shit up. I'd kill it on that show. These are going to be some of the dumbest answers compiled into one video. I've seen some pretty stupid answers on the show. I mean, I've come up with some pretty stupid answers while I'm playing at home. But no one's recording me, so there's no proof of that unless I say it. Like I said in the intro, make sure you guys use code SHARP on G Fuel. Also, if you guys, that noise, if you guys are hearing that, Linda is also working. She's making her cake toppers. Me and her both work from our apartment. We have to share the room when we work, so you hear diligently cutting paper in the back.
Anthony, give me a boy's name that starts with the letter H.
Jose.
Oh, we started out hot. And you can tell Steve is already like looking like, that shit wasn't right. You can see all the females in his family are clapping, hitting the good answer. I'm assuming this woman in the middle is his mother. She's just got to be supportive. She knows. She's just clapping. They're all saying good answer. My dude Roger is literally sitting there holding the table, looking like, bruh, you think Jose starts with an H? Are you fucking kidding me? Like, we're out here trying to win a new sedan for the family, and we're putting you in the lineup? Who picked this guy for the roster? Even Steve Harvey's face is like looking over to the director like, is this guy serious? What the fuck? The first lady in the pink is trying to figure it out. She's like,
Jose with an H. Name something that follows the word pork.
You pie.
Oh my god, you know it's bad when his whole family's laughing. His dad, is that his dad? His dude's looking down like, dead ass? It's always the funniest is to see the team's reaction because they're either like sitting there just blindly clapping because, you know, they didn't listen. They're like, good answer. Or they're just like, what the? Like, are you fucking kidding? I'd be roasting my family. If I was on there and they started saying some shit like, you pine, I'd be like, come, we're on TV. Are you kidding me right now? Like, you gotta bring your A game. Steve had to go back with a
Name
double take.
Something that follows the word pork.
You pie.
Huh?
He said, huh?
You pie. Pork pie.
You asshole!
He said, fuck this shit.
He said, Q pie. What is coupon?
Hey Siri, what is coupon?
In marketing, a coupon is a ticket or a document that can be redeemed for a financial discount.
She thought I said coupon. This is Siri's face when you fucking ask her what is coupon.
I feel you. I feel you. It's number one.
On my mama.
Oh, he said number one on my mama. Yo, his mama's over here like, I'm gonna put that shit on me. Let's see if it's up there.
Coupon! Name a country a man with a mustache should visit to meet a woman with a mustache.
France.
Yeah. France.
A woman with a mustache in France.
Harris.
Oh, come on. Oh, no. Oh, now he realizes he fucked up.
You want to see?
Yeah, I want to see.
I'm going to go pass.
You know, if you have the name Rel and they put you at the end of the table, you're about to have a banger for an answer.
It's hard to do with your eyes open.
Read.
Why is he double clapping? I'm like, yo, good answer. Name something that's hard to do with your eyes open. This motherfucker said read. Look at his, who is that, his sister? Look at her. She's like, what the, read? Oh, Steve's pissed. Oh, who's he calling out? Oh, he's calling out the mama. Don't bring her into this. Oh, shit. I feel like no one up there even knows what he just said.
Name something that's hard to do with your eyes open. This boy in college. He enrolled in that now. He leaned into the mic and said, read, Steve. Some politicians belong in the White House, others belong in the blank house.
Well, Steve, if they're good, they belong in the White House.
Let's go, DeQuincy. If you don't know the answer, always answer the question with the same question. If some politicians are so good they belong in the White House, the other politicians belong in the White House. Fuck it. It's got to be up there, Steve. Tracy don't get it. She's like looking around like, what's wrong with what he said? Tracy's not sure if she should be laughing or not. She's not sure. Watch it be up there.
Name someone a man might not want to know that he uses Viagra.
I would say the President of the United States.
Bro.
All right.
Dirk. Name someone a man wouldn't want to know that he uses Viagra. The only two answers that are up there are his parents and his kids. This motherfucker went straight for the president. He didn't say his boss. He didn't say maybe his girlfriend or like his random hookup. He didn't say his friends. He didn't say his fucking cousins. He said the president. Who the hell knows the president and would think that the president would care if you're on Viagra? Just about every president is probably on fucking Viagra.
All right, you guys.
He starts hyping himself up. All right, guys. All right, yep. We got 0 points, and we're going to stay that way.
Dirk is looking for the president of the United States.
Steve don't even care to try. He ain't going to mess with him.
By far the suckiest answer since I've been the host. Who the hell do you know even knows the president?
I was saving the answers for my team.
He got two wars, a bad economy, an oil spill. He ain't worrying about you using no Viagra. Yeah, you know, in here in the Oval Office today, got so many decisions today. Oh my God, is Dirk on Viagra? Gotta sign that into law. Toya, 100 men, tell me a traffic sign that best describes your love life.
Do not pass go.
All their faces. Look at Charles. You know, Charles looks like the guy from Get Out, older. No, he's sitting there, and Tamika's like, oh, hell, do not pass go. What the fuck? And she's like, isn't that like a Monopoly card? Traffic sign.
It's up there, Steve.
Oh, no.
It's up there.
Ooh, no, it ain't. Do not pass go.
It's up there. Oh, my God.
What does that even mean?
You're driving that little car on the Monopoly board. That ain't no damn traffic sign. Them is instructions. Do not pass go. Name something that a person with long legs might not be able to fit into.
I'm going to go with long pants.
Bruh.
Good answer.
Oh, shit. I think she knows she fucked up. She just probably didn't hear the question. As soon as she said it, she started laughing and told herself, good answer, and clapping. Everyone else on her team's like, are you good? Let's never say it under her breath.
Might not be able to fit into.
She'd be like, good answer.
I'm going to go with long pants.
Good answer. No one else on her team said good answer until she did. He's got to reread it. He's like, hold up. Did I read that wrong? This is another Miss Universe fucking situation.
We're looking for them long pants.
Oh, what? What? Bro, if I was on the other side, I would be pissed. I would be fucking furious. What do you mean the pants was actually up there? They actually gave her the answer for long pants because pants was in the word. They don't count the adjective. I would be fucking pissed if I was on the other side. Look, Steve is like, what? Are you kidding me? Who's making these rules?
Hey, Rashad, tell me something that a pilot might turn on after plane takes off.
The engine's already on, so the engine.
What? The fuck? Why would he answer it? And then answer it. Why would he say that?
Fasten your seatbelts. I'm going to turn these engines on and see if we can't maintain altitude.
I feel like people get on the show and they just get nervous and then just shit just slips out. Because he even answered, he's like, well, the engine's already on, so I'm going to say the engine. Motherfucker, what?
Nancy.
You got it.
I could never make love someone to look like my who?
My lovely husband.
Oh, shit. The guy in the middle of the ball guy. Is that her fucking husband standing to the right? There's no way that's her husband. That dude just died inside if that's her husband. Even Steve is like, why does Steve look like he's on an episode of The Office and he's looking into the camera?
Steve, there's only one. There's nobody better than my husband.
Yeah, we are.
No.
Yeah, she's trying to save what she said.
The question.
Oh, that's her husband. Oh, they got to put him on camera.
Let me set it up here for you.
Oh, no.
I could never make love to someone to look like my
husband.
Oh, man, she said it with extra off that time. Oh, fuck.
Caitlin, what's the first question somebody asks when they wake up from a coma?
What's, like, new on the radio?
Comment down below. You're in a coma for 4 years. You come out of a coma and someone's next to your bedside, your best friend, your wife, your mom, your dad. What's the first thing you ask them? It's been 4 long years. What's the first question you ask them? I want to know if anyone's curious as to what the fuck is on the radio.
What Justin Bieber song is hitting now?
I'm on the radio every morning. I hope to God something. I want somebody to think of me first. Tell me another way people say mother.
Mama.
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 Mommy.
Mommy.
Mom, mommy, mother, mammy, right? They say mammy. Can you say it in Spanish? Madre? Or no? Probably no Spanish.
Nanny.
Nanny? Well, I call my mom the nanny. She gonna smack me upside the head.
Nana.
Nana. I feel like that's like a grandparent's name. Oh, she looking to come with a heat. Oh, she got it. She got it. She's puzzling.
What about Steve Nana?
They already fucking said that. They already said that. Yeah, cut the commercial.
Didn't you say Nana?
I did say that, Steve, yes.
Nana.
Uh-huh. And I said Nana.
Oh, she said Nana, and she said Nana.
What is you saying? Stop clapping.
People clapping in the back.
In Spanish or something.
What about mommy?
Okay. Mommy. Did she not see mommy is up there?
Oh, mommy.
Right.
Not mommy. Y'all crazy.
They're gonna give her another try.
People say mother.
Oh, she's whispering. She's got it now.
What about mommy? Oh, get off mommy.
Yeah, cause that's yeah. See that's the see.
No way like she said like, okay, the like, same look shit.
Y'all stop laughing at this, mommy. Now watch this here, mommy. Y'all would have had time to think of something by now. Right.
Okay. Now, they're giving her another chance. People say mother. If she says mommy again.
Nana.
Oh my God. This lady is fucking trolling. Look at him. He's so pissed. Yo, the people on the other side are like, what the fuck? Are we going to get a shot at this? Oh my God.
This shit can't be happening.
They're giving her another chance. No this way she right says here. The same
whatever
shit.
You say, we're going to flip it over. All right, you ready, Sheila? Tell me another way people say, no, just hell, just tell me another way you say mother, because.
Oh, no.
Well, Steve, I would say mom, but the answer mom is always
oh, my
up
God.
There. Right, well, let's just flip that shit over.
Let's just flip that shit over. He said, fuck this. We ain't giving you no more chances. Oh, my God. She had to be trolling. They need a follow-up interview with her. They need to take her from Family Feud and put her on Dr. Phil and give her a rap career and figure out what the fuck going on. Because Sheila, there's no way she's answering like that over and over and over again. They gave her like 6 or 7 tries. Comment down below which one y'all thought was the dumbest. Let me know what you guys thought of the video. Make sure you guys click the subscribe button if you guys are not subscribed. And let me know what you guys thought of the video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you guys very much for watching. As always, your boy Sharp. I'm out. Peace.